This is Chronicle on WCVB Channel 5.
Newborns on the back roads.
You'll meet the cows, you'll meet our pigs, our chickens, our ducks.
New life on the main street.
The town is totally transformed.
Surrounded by the Berkshires, a sleepy city reawakens with creative energy.
It's all right here.
Here, cheeky products sell.
A little bit retro and defiantly ridiculous.
Artists get exercise.
It's like a gym for makers.
Drama returns downtown. Even cocktails get creative.
We're just trying to promote art, drinking art.
The main streets and back roads of Pittsfield, next on Chronicle.
Good evening, everyone. Tonight, we're headed west to the Berkshires, and we're not alone.
No, the city of Pittsfield is attracting a crowd, artists and entrepreneurs drawn by affordable space and a can-do energy.
Springtime is never a sure bet out here in Berkshire County. Winter often slow to relax its hold over these hills and valleys. But that doesn't mean you can't find renewal and rebirth. Take Pittsfield, the Berkshire's county seat. After decades of decline, signs of new life are everywhere.
Obviously, it's well known that the Pittsfield's taken a few blows with GE leaving and others, but it's really been on the upswing for quite a long time with the expansion of new restaurants and a new hotel and a whole range of other cultural attractions.
Adam Hines grew up in the area before heading off to the Mideast to work for the United Nations. He had no qualms about downshifting from the world stage to the old neighborhood.
Ultimately, this is where you get that connection with nature, that connection, closeness to family, and creating a community. And so this is where I was always going to come back to.
It doesn't hurt that the living comes easy here. Rents in Pittsfield are quite reasonable by Berkshire standards. Hines lives in a converted seed warehouse in the middle of the city.
Sitting in my living room here, you can see mountains literally all the way around us. And yet we're in a city of 43,000 people. And within the limits of that city of 43,000 people, I can go skiing, I can go mountain biking, I can hop on a lake. It's all right here.
Of course, nothing happens anywhere without a little kickstart.
I really believed in the power of like a really sincere coffee shop. Like I really believed that I could help bring us all together.
Jess Lamb is all about local product.
I was born and raised right here in Pittsfield for the most part, right down the street.
After time spent in Boston and Brooklyn, Lamb saw an opportunity to make a mark in her hometown. She opened Dottie's, an all-organic coffee shop and community gathering spot. She wasn't the only one going all in on Pittsfield.
There's a lot of people who were coming here that wanted to be a part of something new and fresh, and there was a lot of affordable opportunities for people to take advantage of.
About 15 years ago, Pittsfield's empty buildings and cheap rents began drawing the attention of artists. Long shuttered storefronts were suddenly alive with color and energy.
I was a little hesitant. My husband was all excited about this building. I'm like, honey, it's in Pittsfield.
Crispina French, originally from Stockbridge, a fiber artist and clothing designer.
And like this type of knit with a lot of texture in it is something that people are drawn to.
Her medium of choice, recycled sweaters, which she transforms into clothing, pillows, rugs, and blankets.
Wool's really cool. It's kind of a magic fiber.
But back to that building she and her husband bought in 2006. In this city filled with large churches, French decided to take a leap of faith.
Previously, it was a Roman Catholic church for the French Canadian population of Pittsfield.
Welcome to the Shire City Sanctuary, an events space that hosts crafts fairs, music, and performance art. Downstairs, a maker's space,
where we have a screen printing studio, a sewing lab, and a commercial kitchen, and those are all shared workspaces.
Members of the sanctuary pay monthly dues for access to the equipment.
It's like a gym for makers.
At one time, French had 40 employees working on her designs, supplying big retailers like Crate & Barrel with her pillows and rugs. But a growing family coincided with a shrinking economy, and she decided to alter course, downsizing her business and developing the maker's space.
I kind of look at this church as sort of like it fits nicely into my methodology of reuse and recycling. We're not religious people, but we like to try to bring people together that share a commonality of creativity.
A creativity that's bringing new energy to this old city in the hills.
Pittsfield is really a blank canvas. Like, this is one of those rare opportunities where you can come and really create and paint and draw and sculpt the city that you want to be a part of. And so I just like to welcome and like encourage people to come here and try it on and be a part of it, because it's really special.
Yeah, and she believes in Pittsfield because she's expanding. She's opening a new bakery, Tyler and Pine, and it's about a mile away from her coffee shop.
And back to that Shire City Sanctuary, which was in the old Catholic Church. There's a proposal now on the table to lease part of the space to a cannabis grow house for both medicinal and recreational marijuana in the site of the old church. I'll leave you to fill in the blanks there. I'm going to stay safe.
Good call. All right, we dare you to take a drink of a pick-me-up called Fire Cider.
Hey, Dana, you mind if I tell them how we make fire cider?
Definitely not for every taste.